defense. He's going for speed. She's all alone in a time of need. Because he's racing and pacing and plotting the course. He's fighting and biting and riding on his horse. He's going the distance.
First and the third. Second move is the first. Just pull one out.
But notice you're repping some new gear there, looking a bit different.
Yeah, she came up good. Thanks to Emma at EB Graphics hooking us up with a fresh suit. Did an awesome job, so can't thank her enough. Looks awesome.
It does look awesome. About that,
cruising really just not worth ripping your car up.
No,
wet track like that. So. Yeah, write that one off. Go again.
What'd you come out on?
5, I think it was.
Yep,
probably finished there too.
Yeah, you can see how muddy it was. Let's take a look under the car on the wing. Going to need some scraping.
We'll be right back.
you've just said you got fuel leaking somewhere. What do you reckon it is?
I'm not sure. I had a bit of an issue with the carby clogging out fuel at the back and spraying, filling it in. So seems to be getting worse, and the fuel pressure light come on. So something's got to happen here. Just got to have a look at it and see what's going on.
Okay. Overall though, this ran a bit better than the first heat.
Yeah, car felt really good early in that one. Like, it was super fast. It just seemed to, I dropped away a little bit as it was losing fuel pressure, obviously, and I was probably buttoned off as well because I don't want to hurt my motor. So I wish it was right because it would have been really fast, I think.
Yeah.
Felt really good.
You were looking really fast at the beginning there. You can definitely see where you started to drop off.
Yeah.
Did you make some changes in between from heat one to heat two? What did you do?
Made a gearing change. Other than that, not much. Just cleaned the mud out of the steering rack. I filled the rack up with mud in the first heat. I was having trouble steering, so I just wanted to get through the first one unscathed and show what we got off the front there in that one.
Mm-hmm. Back to work now.
Yeah, definitely that high. What about the carby nut?
Go down to it there.
Fuck, you were flying,
man.
Fuck,
you
were hooking in there.
I wasn't in the end.
No, in the end
you were.
That's alright.
Oh, that's perfect, man.
Like that?
Oh, no.
Yeah, you can, bro. It's right there where the funnel is. You can see. That's enough.
Yeah. That black car is actually. That's going to be nice. That's going to be really well. Can't come on.
Perfect.
Jam on the trailer, mate. That's the one you want in.
Yeah, man, yeah.
we didn't make it out onto the feature. What happened?
We're fighting some fuel issues all night, and kept chipping away at it all night, trying to get things running better, but it kept dropping fuel pressure on me, so decided not to run the feature and play it safe. Didn't want to do any damage to the engine, so just can't afford to do that. So decided, as I said, tried a few things to rectify the issues, decided not to run the feature. It was a shame, actually, because the car itself felt really good all night, but it just didn't get to show its potential.
We could really see there on the heat 2 and heat 3 how well you were really starting off and going forward, but then as you went on, it was starting to drop off. Was that because of that fuel pressure?
Yeah, definitely. Like in the second heat there, especially, you're saying it just took off like a jet at the start of the race, and then I could just feel it fading on me real quick, and then obviously with the fuel delivery issues, I sort of couldn't drive at 10 tenths, so I sort of backed off and just coasted to the end. But yeah, it's a shame because the car was so good.
And when you were in the car, could you see that was the issue? Were you getting any of that spray coming up and affecting your vision?
Yeah, well, that's where the problems started from. Like, I keep getting sprayed with methanol out the back of the carburetor, so I tried a few things to rectify that, but kept filling my visor in, making it hard to see. But not only that, the fuel pressure light started flickering, so I'm having some fuel pressure issues too, which I think possibly is related to the fuel pump. But gonna have to get home here and go right through it all and see what I can find.
Potentially, you're supposed to be racing at Eastern Creek for the first time this coming Saturday. How are you feeling? Do you think you'll make it?
It's hard to say, really, now. Like, you don't want these sort of issues, especially at this time. Like, we're only a week out from the first ever race at Eastern Creek. So, it's not looking the best, but hopefully we can diagnose our issues and get the parts we need in time and go from there. Like, type of fuel pump required, so I might have to get that out from WA or something, so with express freight, so I don't know, we might see that midweek if that's the case, but it doesn't leave you a lot of time to do everything, so we'll just I'll give it a crack anyway, and hopefully I can make it. If not, what do you do?
Well, Aaron Barnes, hopefully we do make it and this week moves smoothly. Fingers crossed.
Hopefully, but things aren't really running smooth at the moment. Hopefully we can turn it around.
You got to get out of bad luck eventually.
Yeah, that's it.
This will be your week. Fingers crossed.
Yeah, we'll see.